Okay, so I don't have a cup or anything to use for my wash. They haven't come in the mail yet. So what I'm just gonna go ahead and make my own container. And you could do this with any plastic or can. So as you can see, we now have a cup that we can use for mixing, and we're just going to use it to make our wash. Now, when people say wash, what they mean by that, let me rinse this out real quick. Okay, so here are the three basic things that you're going to need to begin your wash. You're going to need something, some container with water in it. You're going to need some charcoal, and here we have a regular charcoal kit. What I like to do is take my X-Acto knife and take one of the crayons, and they come in different tinsels. Here's a soft crayon as compared to the hard crayon. I find that the soft ones are easier to use. And you could either use the sharp end of your X-Acto knife or the dull end. I prefer to use the dull end because I don't see any need in getting it to dull it, but you just kind of scrape some of this charcoal in there into your liquid. And essentially what you're doing is you're just making a black dirty wash. You're making some dirty water. And your results may vary. Of course, you might use a different brand, or you might even use a different scraping tool. I've seen people use potato peelers to do this. And you might not need, but it doesn't take much. As you can see, that water is already starting to get a little brackish. And here's the secret formula, is a little bit of dishwasher soap. And if you see how it breaks the surface tension there? Did you get a good look at how that broke up? And you'll see how, once we mix it up, you'll see, I probably put too much water in here. We're probably gonna have to add more charcoal than is necessary. But the idea is you don't want to get it too, doesn't need to be real black, but it does need to have some tint to it, because essentially you are going to use it to simulate soot or weathering dirt on the side of the aircraft. And so I find that this is a good way to get that look. And once you get, of course, if you have a container that you can keep your wash in, that you can save this for next time, you know, once you've mixed it up. And this is probably really thin. And, you know, some people use multiple layers when they put it onto their aircraft. And I really just want to show you the theory of using a wash to affect that weathering, what you're looking for, to get that weathering look that you're after. Okay, now let's take the part that you want to, and I don't know if you can see this really good, but there's panel lines here on the wing surface that this has already been primered. And what we're going to do is we're going to just put a gentle wash over this entire thing and let it dry. And then we'll wipe away the residue once it's dry. And it will leave the brackishness. We'll find the low spots in the panel. Now, for this exercise, for this type of work, I like to use the thicker brushes. Now, here's a tester's sable number 10, and it's this particular design of brush is called a filbert brush, and I like this because it allows for a really quick application. You don't need to be very precise. And again, the idea is you are washing this model. You're washing that brackishness onto the model, so you're not going to be. You're probably going to do this a few times. You're going to repeat the cycle. You're going to, you know, let it dry. You're going to rinse it, wash it, put it on here, allow it to dry, and then come back to it. And wipe after you've wiped off the residue. And it typically would take about an hour to dry But as you can already start to see, the recessed lines within the panel structure are already starting to pop out, already starting to become more evident. And that's really what you want. This is prior to, and this is important, this is before you put your actual paint on it. So this is just primer underneath it. And we have yet to paint, put the we're going to use a natural metal finish or aluminum on it. But this is how you get those panel lines to really kind of pop out from your paint job. And that's, like I said, once you've got that wash, this is a very light wash, very low pigment, and I probably should have made it thicker than this, you know, put more charcoal in there. But for demonstration purposes, this is to show you how that dishwashing liquid acts as a, what's the opposite of coagulant? It makes it more viscous and allows that liquid in the pigment to really carry into the recessed parts. So that's all you need to do. And of course, you're going to let it dry. And it's important to try to get all of your surface areas that are going to really need it. Like, some won't need it at all. Some will need it more than others. But like here, I might use it on the engine components. I might put some on there. And I might use some on the landing gear as well. Yeah, so nothing fancy, nothing excessively hard to do, but a critical step in making your model really look good, to really make it pop, make it stand out in the crowd. If there's other people competing against you, or maybe a neighbor and you are building one simultaneously, this little step here is going to make yours stand out. It's going to be just and it's a very little investment of time and energy, you know, for the result that it'll bring. And like I said, yeah, this wash is way too thin. I need to make it a little bit more pronounced. You can see now why some people use potato peelers for this application. Get that water really brackish. Yeah, that's a little bit thicker. And you know, apply it liberally. Don't worry about saving money when it comes to getting it on there. And like I said, this is one of many coats. You're going to put multiple coats on here, but I just wanted to take the time to show you how to do this prior to your putting your main coat on there. You know, here's the engine cowling. This is one of those models where it's optional whether or not you want to allow the engine to be visible. Have the cowling off, so that there's a lot of people, modelers, that really pride themselves on doing very miniature micro work, and they like to show off their engine components. You know, they have the cylinders, you know, where you can see the spark plug wires and the cylinders and everything. I'm not one of those people. I find that I'd rather spend that time on the cockpit or on other areas. But if you're so inclined, then you certainly want to get all your engine components washed and have that detail really pop out. Okay, I think that's enough for today, and we'll get started on this later, and keep following us. Props, scale, aircraft model building. And next we're going to put, I think we're going to go with a coat of paint. And what we're going to do is, this is a primitive build. So everybody's saying, well, I don't have an airbrush. I don't have the means to do that with an airbrush. Well, using this type of spray, this rattle can, I think this costs $5. And I think that's a really good investment. This is gloss metal silver. And what this will allow you to do is to get an pretty close. You'll pretty much be able to get a similar aircraft airbrush look, but without the investment. I mean, your average airbrush now is probably going for about $125 for the bare minimum, you know, basic standard made in China version. But for $5, that's a, you know, we're trying to keep this project primitive and try to do the bare minimum. You're really going to be surprised at how smooth the finish and how good your model will look with just this rattle cam. All right, so that's enough for today, and thank you for coming to the site.